Boy, those kids are murder, aren't they?
Oh, I know they're a little annoying at times, but don't forget they're the ones that made you. Of course, I did a pretty good job of building up myself. Yes, sir, a lot of water's going under the bridge, Gary. We've come a long way. I remember when we started, the only crowds we drew were bill collectors and process servers.
That was only a stopover on our way up.
I know, but sometimes it seemed to me like it was the end of the line. Remember the night we met? You were singing at a joint up the Hudson with a five-piece outfit, getting paid off a meal ticket a week. Yes, sir, we've really come a long way together.
Okay, we'll put it all in our memoirs.
Remember when we auditioned for Hofer? We tossed the coin to see what our last $5 went for dinner or a new tie. Then I sat up all night settling the contract.
And what a contract.
Well, it was a start anyway. And now, I got a new deal with the Arvin Chapman. It's as good as any contract ever written.
Congratulations.
Five straight years, Gary. Top money, choice of program, five straight years.
5 years?
Yes, sir.
Tied hand and foot to an illiterate old windbag like Hofer for 5 years? I'm surprised at you, Doug.
Look, this is a great contract. I fought pretty hard to get this.
Yeah, I imagine so. It's a great spot for you. You just sit back for 5 years and pick up big commissions. That's not my idea of a contract, but this is.
You mean you made a new deal?
Yep.
On your own, without me?
New sponsor, new agency, starting fresh. I don't need anybody to front for me anymore, Doug. They come to me now.
Sure, they come to you now. But when you were broke, they didn't pay your bills and your back rent. They didn't buy clothes for you and tell you how to wear them. They didn't give you a place to live.
Well, now, take it easy, Doug. I'll never forget what you've done for me. I'm taking you with me on my new job. You can be my secretary or something. How's your shorthand?
It's in pretty good shape.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Doug. I'm just kidding about shorthand. We can work out some kind of a deal.
I happen to have a deal with Hutch, remember?
Hutch? Well, he won't want you without me. The only reason you've been there as long as you have is because of me.
Oh, really? Thanks. You know something? I'm gonna get myself a new Gary Mitchell.
Yeah? Where?
Oh, I'll look under a stone or down a sewer.
This is what you need. This will pick you up.
Oh, thanks, Vi.
Come on, now, drink it. It's strong, hot, and black.
Yeah, black, like my future.
You say that after every program. Drink it, you'll feel better. We've been through much worse than this.
You're a good influence on me, Vi. I'd be lost without you.
Why, Mr. Hutchins, you'll turn my girlish head with your flattery. Feeling better?
Some. It's just that Hofer's writing me for Gary's contract. That ham crooner turns coy on me, the account gets shaky, and the jitters move in on me.
No.
You know something? I don't belong in radio. When I was in college, my ambition was to be a country doctor. With a horse and buggy.
Mm-hmm, little white house.
With green shutters.
Yeah.
So I wind up in this pressure cooker with my nerves all shot.
Well, slip into your cap and gown and we'll make believe you're back at Yale again.
Now, don't joke about something sacred. Yale. You don't know what that means to me.
Ah, another touchdown for the home team.
Well.
There's your contract.
My hero.
Unsigned. He walked out on us.
What?
He signed with another sponsor.
No. You're kidding. That's it. You're kidding. Say, I like a joke, but not at a time like this.
It's true, Hutch, but it doesn't mean a thing. I'll hop a plane from New York tonight and come back with a new star.
Hofer doesn't want a new star. He wants Gary Mitchell, and you let him get away. It's treason. High treason, you Benedict Arnold.
What could I do? I didn't dream that even Gary could turn out to be such a rat. But I can fix that. A fast trip east, and I'll come back with somebody that Hofer is bound to like.
Hofer likes Gary Mitchell. So does Mrs. Hofer. And so do I.
Well, I don't. That half-baked ham.
No, Blake, look. Here's the scheme. You go back to him. Whatever he's getting, we'll top it. We'll package the show and give him ownership.
What? You would bargain with that double-crosser?
I'd bargain with Jack the Ripper.
And get the best of him.
Listen, I'm not just thinking about myself or my pride or my feelings, but look at this office. Think of the overhead. Let's face it, we've got to have Gary Mitchell.
Look, just give me a chance to find somebody new. I'll take the plane tonight.
No. If you want to show up Gary Mitchell, that's your business. But you'll not do it on my time, nor at my expense.
All right, then I'll do it on my own. I quit.
You're fired.
No, Doug, don't be such
I
a hot-headed mule. Wait a minute. Here, lower your blood pressure. Think beautiful thoughts. I'll be right back.